Biotin is a water-soluble vitamin, also known as B7, vitamin H, or coenzyme R, and it acts as a coenzyme for four different types of carboxylases in the mitochondria. But that's not what we're here for. We want to know the exact role of biotin for hair growth. How much of it do you need to take? Does it really thicken your hair? And what are the side effects? Is acne one of them? Does it interfere with lab tests? These are all important questions, and we will answer all of them, so definitely stay with me till the end. Also, real quick, guys, before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm and turn the bell on to stay up to date with new weekly videos. Biotin plays an important role in converting carbohydrates, fats, and proteins into energy, which is important for the body. And the word biotin actually comes from the ancient Greek word biotos, which means life or sustenance. And your body doesn't make biotin on its own, so you will need to get it from food, with eggs, salmon, legumes, and broccoli being high in biotin. And if you type in biotin anywhere on the internet, it is always tied back to its use for hair, skin, and nails. This is because not having enough biotin or being biotin deficient has the symptom profiles of causing brittle nails, hair loss, and red and scaly skin, right? So the idea was to increase the biotin as a method to mitigate the conditions from occurring. So if low biotin causes these symptoms, take biotin to reverse them. The other assumption is that extra biotin can lead to additional beauty benefits. While it seems to be a very logical idea to do, to date, unfortunately, there's no conclusive evidence that biotin supplements improve the health of or appearance of hair, nails, or skin, unless you actually have a biotin deficiency. And having a biotin deficiency in the US is a rare phenomenon. So unless if you have chronic alcoholism, are a heavy smoker, have a biotinidase deficiency that is usually autosomal, are pregnant or breastfeeding, which by the way, your prenatal vitamins probably already have biotin, or have malabsorption issues, the good news is you probably don't have a biotin deficiency. Your hair loss is probably due to another cause. There's also an acquired biotin deficiency that comes from eating raw egg whites, which contain avidin, and avidin binds to biotin and prevents its absorption. But this can be prevented by cooking the eggs, which denatures avidin, so you can absorb the biotin and not have to worry about it. Other foods to watch out for, believe it or not, are foods like eggnog, Caesar salad dressings, and some mayonnaises that are said to contain avidin, so keep that in mind over the holidays. And some medicines like valproic acid or long-term antibiotics can change the gut flora, which can cause a biotin deficiency too, just FYI. Looking at the review of the use of biotin for hair loss, most of the conclusions you find go something like this. In cases of acquired and inherited causes of biotin deficiency, as well as pathologies such as brittle nail syndrome or uncombable hair, biotin supplementation may be of benefit. However, we propose these cases are uncommon and that there is a lack of sufficient evidence for supplementation in healthy individuals. But of course, this isn't going to stop people from starting to take biotin, as the anecdotal evidence and the number of supplements coming out on the market utilizing this deficiency prevails. Also, something worth mentioning is that like other B vitamins, biotin is water soluble. So if you take more than you need, your body isn't gonna store it and send it to your scalp or skin at a later date. You're naturally going to get rid of the excess biotin when you pee. Now, this doesn't mean you go overboard and take higher and higher doses of biotin. The adequate intake, by the way, is about 30 micrograms a day, which a normal Western diet already gives you about 35 to 70 micrograms a day. And I know you might be thinking that doesn't seem like much since you see supplements as high as 25,000 micrograms on Amazon. And speaking of these amounts, no evidence in humans has shown a toxicity of biotin even with high intakes. Therefore, there's no established upper limit or toxic level for biotin as of yet. But with that said, there are about three precautions you need to know of before you take it. So let's start with the first one. One, it can cause acne in those that are more acne prone. This is because it may interfere with the body's absorption of vitamin B5, which helps stop acne. B7 and B5 are competitors, so an excess or shortage of any of these can occur, which can cause acne. Number two, you need to discontinue biotin for at least 2 to 5 days prior to obtaining a biotin streptovitamin-dependent assay in a lab test, which will be mostly your thyroid function tests where biotin interference will be observed. Other labs include troponin, vitamin D tests, PTH, FSH, LH. It can cause a false negative reading, which means that test results look normal when in fact they are abnormal. So something to be aware of. And number three, before you buy a biotin supplement for thinning hair or brittle nails, it's important to rule out potential underlying causes for your symptoms. I always say hair thinning is multifactorial. Find out the root cause before assuming that it's biotin and spend a lot of money for something you don't need. Always make sure to go with a brand that is highly reputable and has third-party testing to ensure purity and quality if you choose to do so. And keep in mind that it doesn't have to be a supplement. There are biotin hair oils, shampoos, and serums. And if I were to absolutely pick one, and no, this isn't sponsored, just a personal preference, I would go with a shampoo that not just only had biotin, but also had a blend of other DHT blocking ingredients that are proven to help with hair thinning, which we mentioned a lot on this channel already. So subscribe not to miss out on that. And one that looks nice in my opinion, and that is free of SLS, is the one by PURA, which I've linked down below for you. It comes with a conditioner as well, so check that out in the description below. It contains rosemary oil, which has proven benefits for hair loss. But here's what I want you to look at. It's other ingredients. Saw palmettos on there, black cumin seed, pumpkin seed, green tea, amla, which I'll be discussing soon, and so much more. Go ahead and check out the link below. It's an affiliate link, so doing so will support the channel, and I greatly appreciate all the support you've shown me so far, but don't feel like you have to go with this one. Like I said, it's just a personal opinion. I'm actually more curious to hear from you guys though. Let me know what your thoughts are on biotin. Would love to read them down below. In the meantime, guys, click the subscribe button down below for the YouTube algorithm, and I'll see you guys on the next one.